My name is Dr. Nehemiah Mabry. I'm a structural engineer in Raleigh, North Carolina. I work for the firm Simpson Engineers and Associates, and we design, analyze, and inspect bridges.
So what we have here is a two-span concrete bridge. It's going over a four-lane highway, and we're gonna take a look and see what we can find during our inspection.
There are many reasons for why a bridge might exist. A bridge could cross a narrow stream, it could cross a large body of water, or it could cross an existing road, and that is what we refer to as grade separations. As you have your existing road profiles, it could exist in the form of a curve, or a tangent, which is a straight line, or any combination in between. Then you overlay on top of it a proposed bridge, which also could have a curve, or it could be in a straight line. But whatever the profile of the bridge in the existing road may be, once they intersect, they form an angle. And that angle allows you to be informed on how long you should make your structure, what are the sizes that you should involve, what are the widths, what are the clearances, what is necessary to make sure your bridge is properly designed.
If you look over at the bridge deck, in the eastbound lane, we have a number of longitudinal, transverse, and diagonal cracks. What we would do is quantify the total square feet of cracks here on the deck, and then we would note that and report that on our bridge report.
There are a lot of tools that we use now as engineers that didn't exist 20, 30 years ago. Likewise, there are a lot of tools that will exist 20, 30 years from now that we currently don't have. And with each iteration of technology development, of innovation, there is a change in the way that engineers relate. Engineers actually practically perform their jobs. But what doesn't change is the understanding of the math and the rationale behind the work that we do. So for instance, for now we use a lot of software that run the calculations, that spit out the answers, but we have to actually look at the numbers and know if they make sense. Does this make sense physically? Does this make sense based on the input? Are there any things in here that I need to take note of as I continue to tell the software what I want to get back? Now, as we look forward to the future, when it comes to inspection, we have drones. We have unmanned automated vehicles that can fly and see things visually, or at least take footage or images of things that then, as an engineer, you have to look at and analyze the same way that we analyze now. Only then we won't have to climb over everything. Then we just have to look at the footage. But nevertheless, the theory and the background and the knowledge stays the same, but the way that you carry it out, that's where technology comes in. It can actually save us a couple of deep breaths, and we can preserve a little bit of sweat from the time that we put in. I'm a person who still has the interest in both the technical and the creative. So even as a full-time engineer, I like to engage in a number of outreach projects related to STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math. And so I worked through an initiative that I started when I was a grad student called STEM Media. And through it, I'm able to create creative projects, digital media that goes online. I'm able to go into classrooms and perform workshops. I'm able to do outreach with college students, work with businesses, and people that are really trying to support the STEM push and STEM efforts that exist in our country today. This really, really excites me because I'm able to inspire and then be inspired. So it's sort of a symbiotic process as I go out and do outreach. It then inspires me to come back into the office and do the best I can. And the more work that I'm doing as it relates to designing structures or analyzing the truss bridge then gives me a lot of material and a lot of information that I then want to go back out and share then with the STEM community. And so that type of balance between the technical and the creative, you know, the social as well as the calculated, allows me to really just feel fulfilled in this career that I now have. The world is waiting on your ideas. It would be a sad day if an opportunity came for you to present your idea to the world, but you didn't have the tools to build it. You didn't have the tools necessary to move it from idea to reality. And that is really how I began to look at math. And I began to look at the basis of calculus and pre-calculus. I began to realize that these are tools that I'm putting in my toolbox. So now as a bridge engineer, I have a toolbox that I've developed while I was in school to be able to craft this dream, to craft these ideas, and actually bring it to reality. It's impossible to predict the future. You never know what's coming your way. In fact, the one thing that the world needs may be the thing that you think of now, but you gotta make sure you have the tools. You have to make sure that you're developing the skills. You never know what's coming. And so I wanna make sure that you have your toolbox that is as full as possible so that one day you can give the world the dream that we've been waiting on.